Language has never been an issue for her. And like a true artist, she believes that art can be art in any language. I'm talking about Tamannaah Bhatia. And Tamannaah, I truly believe that you've transcended beyond that. And I feel it only is an advantage when you know so many languages.
It helps. It helps to communicate because India is such a huge country. And we have so many different languages in which, you know, people communicate. So, and also it's a reflection of different cultures. I mean, essentially, India has so many different, you know, kind of cultures. So we're just trying to kind of use that in a way that that art then becomes accessible to everybody in their own convenient language. You know?
Yeah.
You know, for me, I don't know, I guess I never planned much of my career. A lot what happened to me just kind of happened. But one thing was constant for me, and that was, the want to face the camera and, to just be a performer, to enact scenes, to play characters, to, live another life, like be different people. So I guess that process is what I enjoyed the most, and I still do. So I think that's the only thing that matters to me even now.
You were very young when you started in this industry. I would like to hear that story of yours. The struggles, the successes, the disappointments and the highs. Can you tell me a little about that?
Well, I started working when I was in school. That was my first film. But I think properly, like when I started doing my South films, I must have just passed my 10th grade. And I think I was still figuring out whether this is something I can pursue for a lifetime, because I'm not from the film industry, so I had no I had literally no mentor, I had no guiding force, I did not know how it would go. So I think also because my family, like there are a lot of doctors in my family, there are lots of they're all very, very highly educated. So I was thinking, okay, maybe I'll focus on my studies also, and if this works out, then that would be the best thing. And to be honest, like once work took off, which was around when I was around 17 years old, I had literally no time to even continue my education, which became like, it was a hard decision I had to make at that point in time in my life, because I really wanted to study. At the same time, I was doing something that I really loved, and I could vision myself doing it for the rest of my life. So I think it was a very conscious decision. So I studied till my 12th grade, and thereafter I just couldn't continue studies. And I was a good student. I was one of those strange people who like to study. But then I clearly loved to be in front of the camera a lot more. So I made a choice at that point in time. But I think now is a great time. Yeah, you can do everything you want to do. You can study. There's no age for anything. There's no time for anything. So it's up to you where you want to invest your energy and time. And the moment you make up your mind, this is what you want to do, I think we have a lot more freedom to do it just because of sheer technology that exists.
Like you said, you did not have a godfather. You did not have a mentor who would tell you where to go. When you got that chance, were you intimidated when you entered this world?
You know, strangely, when I started working, I think I was a lot more secure.
Really?
I was a lot more confident. I was a lot more... I didn't really care of what people thought of me. And I think that's probably the reason I could survive, although I was so young and I was in an industry where I didn't even speak the language. And I was working with people much older than me at that point of time. It didn't daunt me at all. I was just too much into trying to just be in front of the camera, do my job. Like that was so much of my energy that what people were thinking, what they perceived of me, whether it was right or wrong, I was really not processing that at all. I think probably after I got success and I got, when people started liking my work is when I started getting more critical of myself and I started being more conscious of what I was doing versus when I started off. So actually that phase was much easier. Of course, like making choices was difficult because I didn't know who was who. Like in the South Indian film industry also, I didn't know what was the body of work that the person has done. So for me, that was research, like to understand why this film is good, why is this film liked by people, or this maker liked by people, or these actors liked by people, just to kind of understand that.
Yeah.
Because that's how you make choices, right? Whether you want to do this, you don't want to do this. So yeah. First you have to figure out what kind of an industry you're working in. So for me, the first 5-6 years of my career was just kind of exploring and understanding. So I used to watch a lot of South Indian channels on TV because I was just trying to understand what kind of music do they like, what kind of you know.
Your research. See,
yeah, it was basically research for me, and also knowing who is who, because I wasn't exposed to that cinema as growing up as a kid. So actually also helped me learning the language, because just surely watching TV, right? So you're learning, you're picking up the language while you're hearing it. And I was at quite like one of those, you know, anyway, you're in that studious age. Yeah. So, you know, everything becomes like a sponge. You grasp a new language much easily. I think for me, a major transition as a person and as an actor was when I had done a lot of South Indian films, and I had a lot of success and a lot of acclaim critically and commercially. And then I was transitioning or trying to do Hindi films, because that's what I grew up on.
Correct.
And theoretically, those choices were, I think, were good choices. But when it actually came on screen, it had completely, gone wrong. And it was hard to see people's reaction being so negative about it. But the thing was, I knew that they were right. Like, I didn't like those films myself either. So there was just, I knew it was a wrong decision. But soon enough, I think, which also kind of made me more aware of the duality of things in life and in the movies, is that right after that is when I got my most, challenging and the most creatively satisfying on-screen experience, and that was Baahubali. So it was just so fast, like, you know, And I like to say that, you know, the failure is not personal. It's a film failing. You know, unfortunately, in our job, especially as actors, the failure or success becomes extremely personal. It's not like you're having a bad day at work. You know, it's not like for any other person, it's like, oh, you know, I made a boo-boo at work, which is fine, which everyone does. And, you know, everyone has not such good days and has, you know, good days at work.
But not everybody knows and hears about how you failed.
Yeah. So, but here it becomes like, it's like a full, like... visual depiction of how your work has failed. I feel like that is a little bit of, I think it becomes so personal for actors. So I think I learned how to take the, the failure of the film and then a success of a film to this extent. Like, so when Baahubali happened, it was like some kind of a explosion has happened, because
the love that you got.
The love that I got was unprecedented for me also, because I hadn't seen that in the South either. So, like people like holding on to you on the roads, and they're like, how did that waterfall happen? You know, like people were so curious about this world that was created. So, so I think that phase of my life was just too much was going on, too much. So I had to just like kind of, and I think I grew up really fast in that phase, because a lot of my ideologies changed while I was in that process of my life.
You came from an industry. South Indian industry, which is a huge industry in its own, जहाँ पे आप already एक established star थी जब आप यहाँ पे आई थी, जैसा आपने कहा. You did films like Himmatwala and Entertainment and Humshakals, just predominantly that she was talking about. You of course critically were really thrashed. उस समय पे when you came in, आपके लिए being a part of the commercial film was more important, because with bigger stars, because you thought that'll get me the eyeballs, that'll get the masses in the theatre. Was that why you think you all threw the decision at that time?
एक बहुत ही अजीब सी बात है कि जब मैंने अपनी साउथ इंडियन फिल्म करियर जब मैंने शुरू किया था, मैंने कुछ फिल्में की थी जो बहुत ही रूरल थी, बहुत ही रियलिस्टिक थी, जो बॉक्स ऑफिस पे अच्छी फेयर हुई, लोगों को पसंद आई, बट उसके तुरंत बाद मुझे ऐसी कुछ कमर्शियल फिल्म में काम करने का मौका मिला जो मुझे जिसने मुझे एक अलग लेवल का सक्सेस दिया. एंड फिर ऐसा एक दौर आया कि मुझे उसी किस्म के फिल्में, मैंने काफ़ी सारे उस किस्म के फिल्में कर ली थी, एंड आई फेल्ट लाइक दैट वाज एंड आई हैड सम गुड कमर्शियल फिल्म्स. सी व्हाट हैपेंस इज कमर्शियल फिल्म्स आल्सो दैट पर्टिकुलर जॉनरा विच वी स्पीक अबाउट इन टर्म्स ऑफ फॉर्मूला और वट एवर दैट जॉनरा इज काइंड ऑफ एड्रेस्ड एज, उन फिल्मों में भी बहुत ही अच्छी फिल्में होती हैं
जी,
विच वी लाइक अगर हम अपने ही लाइफ की हम लोग फिल्में देखें जो हमें बहुत पसंद हैं, दे विल बी सम वेरी कमर्शियल फिल्म्स. सो वो फिल्में मेरे लिए बहुत चली और वो बहुत पसंद की गई और वो अच्छी भी थी. सो मैंने एक्चुअली ऐसा नहीं सोचा था कि जो मैं हिंदी फिल्में कर रही हूँ वो अगर मैं ऐसी करूँगी तो फिर इट विल गेट अ मास, यू नो, लाइक
प्लान नहीं था
ये प्लान नहीं था बट आई फेल्ट लाइक commercial films have that power and they will always have that power of reaching out to a mass audience. And because I already wo kar rahi thi South mein, so it felt like only the natural thing to do it here. And I didn't assess at that point of time ki uske saath eventually kya hoga. So I guess that was not a conscious decision. Yeah. Akshay, Ajay, Saif, I think their actors have, you know, loved and I've adored them on screen. And I think they're, you know, such, they're the finest actors we have in our country. So, I mean, just sharing screen with them was a very enriching experience.
It's after this entire period of films that did not do well. And like you said, you realize that they were not good films. And isliye unhone, you know, it didn't sort of impress anyone. Indian film industry per se, you took a step back. Only to the kind of roles that will have a little bit of meaning. Yeah. Am I right in assessing this?
I think it happened to me, sirf Hindi filmon ke ke maamle mein nahi hua mere saath. Jab maine apni South ki filmein bhi choose karna shuru kiya, usme bhi maine bahut scripts chhaatna shuru kar diya. Like I was like, main sab nahi karna chahti. Main wahi roles karna chahti hu jahan par, you know, jahan par mujhe kuch karne ka mauka mile. और वो एक अच्छे फिल्म के दरमियाँ होना चाहिए. शुड नॉट बी लाइक, यू नो, रोल बहुत बढ़िया है लेकिन वो वाली फिल्म कोई देखना नहीं चाहेगा. बिकॉज अगेन दैट्स नॉट द काइंड ऑफ सिनेमा आई ग्रू अप ऑन एंड आई रिलेट टू. सो दैट वाज नेवर माय आइडिया ऑल्सो बीइंग अ पार्ट ऑफ मूवीज. क्योंकि मुझे फिल्में जो एम्पावर करती हैं या जो लाइक अगर आप एक बुरे मूड में हो, यू नो, आप चाहते हो कि आप एक रिमोट लेके आप टीवी देखो, आप वो फिल्म देखो जो आपको अच्छा फील कराए.
जी,
यू नो, सो आई वांटेड टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ दैट काइंड ऑफ सिनेमा. सो या आई थिंक आई बिकेम मोर कॉन्शियस एंड आई बिकेम मोर अवेयर ऑफ माय ओन रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी एज एन एक्टर. क्योंकि लोग आपका काम इतना पसंद करते हैं, आपके इतने जेन्युइन फैंस हैं, वो आपसे एक्सपेक्ट करते हैं कि आप अच्छा काम करें. सो वो रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी को, यू नो, को ऑलवेज अपने दिमाग में रखते हुए मैंने फिल्में चूज करना शुरू किया.
Suddenly, there's a whole discussion about the clause that you've had in your contracts.
This has been there since forever, the very beginning.
No? But, and I also feel that as an actor, you get to choose what you do, want to do and what you don't want to do. When you kept these clauses that, you know, I don't want to kiss on screen or a bikini or do all of this, there were certain things that you didn't want to change about your personality, which remain. But was it difficult in the industry?
You know, pehli baat, मैं एक बात, आई मीन, आई एम ग्लैड आपने ये सवाल पूछा. मैं एक ये बात क्लैरिफाई करना चाहूँगी कि ये क्लॉज का होना या ना होना, या लाइक आई डोंट किस ऑन स्क्रीन और आई डोंट वेयर अ सर्टेन काइंड ऑफ आउटफिट ऑन स्क्रीन हैज नथिंग टू डू विद इट बीइंग राइट एंड रॉन्ग.
एंड
आई एम नॉट जजमेंटल अबाउट पीपल हु डू दैट, बिकॉज समथिंग लाइक दिस इज अ वेरी पर्सनल चॉइस. एंड या आई मीन फॉर मी, मुझे उस वक्त पर जब मैंने शुरुआत की थी अपनी करियर की, मैं बहुत छोटी थी. एंड माई पेरेंट्स, यू नो, आई डिड स्टफ दैट आई फेल्ट दैट आई न्यू आई वुड बी एबल टू सस्टेन फॉर द रेस्ट ऑफ माई लाइक ईयर्स टू कम. एंड ऑल्सो समथिंग दैट आई वुड बी कम्फर्टेबल विथ माई फैमिली टू वॉच. लाइक दैट्स द काइंड ऑफ फिल्म आई वॉन्टेड टू डू. But today, as an, you know, as a, of course, I've grown up a lot more. Yeah. And I find that I also watch all kinds of movies and I don't think there's anything wrong in it.
Yeah.
I mean, today also, the fact that I'm not doing it is not because it's right or wrong. It's just because
it's
don't want to
choice.
Do it.
Yeah, it's a personal
it's
choice.
Just my decision. But otherwise, I think some of the actors who are such brilliant performers and I love watching their work and, you know, they do what they do on screen, and I think it's great. It's empowering, in fact. You know, I think especially in a country like ours where it's so, you know, your sexuality is always like, you know, it's not cool to kind of express your sexuality, which I find really sad. And we are in that country where everything is so repressed.
Yeah.
So it's not like I'm trying to say that this is right or this is wrong. It's just, it has been my decision, but I mean, I watch all kinds of cinema, I watch all kinds of actors, and they're doing so beautifully for themselves, and they're such inspiring people.
Yeah.
I don't see the fuss around it, but yes, of course, people are curious, ki itne saal, how do you survive without, you know, not, I mean, I let go of a lot of films that came my way, and I was okay with that. I let go of a lot of work that required me to do certain things that I wasn't anyway doing on camera. So it was my decision to not do it and I let go of it. And I'm very happy with those decisions because at the end, aap jo bhi, life mein aap jo bhi decisions lete hain, you have to be comfortable with it and you have to be okay with it and you have to wake up every morning and be,
live
you know,
it.
Live with it. So if that works for you, then then there's nothing to stop you. Especially in a country like ours, I feel like it's so important to let people know that it's to each one his own, you know. We all need to just be ourselves and we have to embrace our own selves. It's not about what the world thinks of us, because we are so busy thinking about what the world thinks of us. And there's a burden, I think, on all of, and sometimes as women, there's a lot more burden of you know, what people think of us, that this whole people business now gets to me really.
Of course, women have a lot of pressure. You know, people are very uncomfortable, and in the world, with women expressing their sexuality openly. You've done a film called Racha with Ram Charan.
Yeah.
And during the time, there was this furore that happened from a certain section of people who found the clothes objectionable. They found certain scenes objectionable. How do you deal with a situation like that?
You know, there is a lot of... it's like a double-edged sword. There are sentiments that people have, and as actors who are considered, you know, who have such a large mass following, somewhere at the back of your head, there is that responsibility that you're catering to a very large audience that has different sensibilities. So when we also choose to do certain things, it is definitely thought over. It's not something we can just jump into. So there's, because it stems out of respect for the audience also, because at the end we are creating content that we want masses to like. So ye jo filmein banti hain jo itne logon ke liye banti hain, at the end unko pasand aani chahiye, to hum unke perspective se bana rahe hain filmein. But at the end, being an actress, you also want to look your glamorous best. So somewhere there's a balance being struck between sensibilities and आप जिस किस्म का प्रदर्शन करना चाहते हैं
जी.
एंड माय डायरेक्टर्स हैव बीन वेरी ग्रेसफुल, एंड यू नो आई हैव ऑलवेज डिसाइडेड व्हाट आई वांटेड टू डू, वेयर, लुक, एंड उन्होंने बहुत ही सपोर्ट किया मुझे, एंड आई थिंक आई लुक माय ग्लैमरस बेस्ट इन द फिल्म दैट जिसका नाम आपने लिया रचा. एंड बट नॉट ओनली रचा, लाइक इवन ड्यूरिंग बाहुबली व्हेन देयर वाज अ सीन जहां पर मैं बैकलेस थी.
Yeah.
There was a song in which they basically want to show that you know, they make love, but usse agar aap ek shot mein darshana chahein, to you know, the director chose to have a bare back and have just those three shots which were there. Mujhe wo aesthetically bahut hi khoobsurat laga. I had no problem with it performing it or showcasing it. But yeah, again, there was a set of audiences jinko pasand aaya, jinko nahi pasand aaya, jinhone the rape of Avantika bola, you know, so they had like, there were different perspectives to the same thing. I think main iske bare mein sirf tab tak sochti hu jab tak main film mein kaam kar rahi hu, and I am creatively executing the stuff. Ek bar wo audience mein aa jata hai, then I don't sit and process it beyond a point, kyunki har insaan ka us pe ek opinion hoga. Hum har ek opinion ko to seriously nahi le sakte, but yes, as a general opinion, like general opinions we anyway take into consideration when we are creating content which is meant for a family audience and a mass audience. I think anywhere in the world, and hamare desh mein bhi, everybody should just be allowed to do whatever they want to do, and if it means if they like to wear a certain kind of clothes, to wo unka decision hona chahiye ki unko kya karna hai apni life ke sath. So I feel like largely, if se film ye baat jo aap keh rahi hain, se filmon tak seemit nahi
hai. Yeah, of course.
It's about people in their real life, in because at the end films are somewhere, you know, they're aspirational. You know, people want to be like the characters or people that they see on camera sometimes, because they're aspirational. But it trickles down to aap apne, you know, real life mein aap kya karna chahte hain, aur aapko wo choose karne ka haq hai, aur aapko wo choose karne ka, aur wo jo aap karna chahte hain wo karne ka pura freedom milna chahiye.
There was also another incident where a director went out and made some ridiculous statements about how he dressed you and how...
Suraj sir, I worked with him on two films prior to what I worked with him on. And us waqt aisa hua tha ki unhone ek comment kiya tha jo shayad unhone ek joking tarike mein kaha. But of course, I don't think unhone us waqt अपने कमेंट का पूरी उनको पूरी तरह से समझ में उन्होंने क्या कहा था, बिकॉज कभी कभी हमारे हम जो कॉन्वर्जेशंस हम यू नो अपने दोस्तों के साथ ऐसे बैठ के हम करते हैं, हम तभी भी रियलाइज़ नहीं करते हम क्या कह रहे हैं, और फिर हम जब एक पब्लिक प्लेटफॉर्म पर जाके ऐसी बातें करते, तो समटाइम्स इट when people understand what you mean, it doesn't go down very well. And it definitely, at that point of time, did not go down well with me. And मुझे लगा, yeah, और I think मुझे लगा कि उस वक्त मुझे कुछ कहना चाहिए और तभी ही हमारी फिल्म रिलीज हुई थी. But I felt it was very important to, you know, address that because it was completely not acceptable. And and yeah, I think I said what I had to say. And I was glad that, you know, my director was, you know, he was sensitive enough to understand that it had offended me. He apologized, and I respect him for accepting his mistake.
This is something that happened long, long time back. But what it also, what I also wanted to highlight was the fact that he took a stand.
Yeah.
You know, you were at a different screening, and I still remember your post very clearly.
Yeah, I was watching Dangal actually.
You were watching Dangal 2016 ka post, and you had very clearly said that I am watching a film about women empowerment. Ke baare mein. Your statement made a lot of difference.
Yeah.
Because I think people, no, and I feel that people, you know, did not expect that.
Yeah, they didn't expect me to talk because I was also working. I mean, the film I just released in, you know, I mean, I really value my relationships in you know, my work arena. My working relationships with everyone matters to me a lot. So, of course, you don't want to make things sour or leave it on a bad note. But at the same time, agar kuch cheez itni matlab galat hai, to aap कभी-कभी उसके बारे में बात करना जरूरी हो जाता है. To be honest, and that's I'm being, you know, utmostly honest here. मुझे काफी सारे चीजों पे ओपिनियन नहीं हूँ. मेरा naturally एक ओपिनियन नहीं बनता क्योंकि मैं अपनी दुनिया में रहती हूँ. I do my own thing. Yeah. I'm a very private person. I'm very loving and, you know, I'm very like excited around people I really love and care about. But otherwise, like my social circle or my, you know, my life is with, yeah, very few people. So because of that, काफी वक्त बहुत सी चीजें होती रहती हैं. अगर मैं हर चीज को react करती रहूँगी तो my entire life will go in just giving a reaction to what people are doing.
Yeah.
You know, and I feel like आजकल हम इतने थके हुए क्यों रहते हैं क्योंकि हम हमेशा हमें social media पे सबके life में क्या हो रहा है उसका पूरा उसकी पूरी जानकारी है जो yeah. शायद पहले हमें नहीं होती थी. So we still not even be so bothered. Now we have so much information that, you know, we are constantly like, ये clarify करो वो clarify करो. But sometimes you just don't have an opinion. Yeah. It's like, okay, there are so many things happening around the world. You will have to talk about things that
matter
to you. And of course, you the ones that you want to make a stand on.
During Me Too, you spoke a lot on your stand. And you obviously said you're with the women. And because you'd worked with Sajid, I think everybody went ahead and said that it's, how do you not know? And, you know, so many women have said, and how have you dealt with it?
Sajid for me is like, you know, he's always treated me like a little sister. And I had worked with him in two films.
Yeah, that's so, exactly why.
So yeah, I think whatever happened, it for me, my individual relationship with him is, you know, is so different that people were talking and I was, of course, listening to everything. But I have my opinion on him and I just gave what I felt was true to me. Fortunately or unfortunately, the attention span of people is becoming lesser and lesser. And people's memories are also so bad. So people have so much strength and so much interest until the interest is still going on. Yeah. But everything seems to die a natural death because of just because of our attention spans nowadays, it's so limited. Of course, uska ek maybe like a hangover of sorts hai. Wo kab tak rahega, bhagwan hi jaane. But filhal to hai, which is good, which is a good thing because that was the idea of it.
Yeah, hopefully it continues. You're doing the remake. You're doing Mahalakshmi, which again is this strong character. You know, it comes as the remake of Queen. Tell me, how are you enjoying this phase?
Of course, like the remake of Queen was something that I really enjoyed doing because that was a character I really loved on screen. And she's a very simple, naive girl, right? That's what we've seen. But my idea was to make it as Telugu, you know, for Telugu audiences to enjoy. So I feel like even filmmakers are, you know, and writers are coming to a point where they want to write better parts. And ये साल मेरे लिए काफी इंटरेस्टिंग रहा है क्योंकि काफी अलग अलग किस्म के किरदार निभाने का मौका मिला मुझे. मेरा सातवां रिलीज जस्ट कुछ दिनों पहले हुआ था, विच वॉज एक्शन, एंड इट वॉज अ कम्प्लीट आउट एंड आउट एक्शन फिल्म वेर आई वॉज डूइंग एक्शन एज वेल. एंड आई थिंक दैट्स सच अ ह्यूज चेंज बिकॉज नॉर्मली आप फीमेल लीड्स को स्क्रीन पर, यू नो, हीरो के साथ आप वो लड़ रहा होगा एंड हीरोइन मतलब
वो बचा रहा
है, हाँ, सो शी इज ऑलवेज गेटिंग सेव्ड. बट यहाँ पर ये एक ऐसी फिल्म है जहाँ पर दोनों हीरो हीरोइन लड़ रहे हैं
जी,
एंड दे आर बोथ यू नो कमांडोज एंड दे बोथ आर एजेंट्स एंड दे आर डूइंग देयर जॉब. So I feel like that's refreshing na, from yeah. what we used to see. And I've had a film which was also Saira, which was you know, period drama where I played a classical dancer.
Yeah.
And she was probably one of the first in history of you know, the freedom fight that we had. She was probably one of the first suicide bombers that there was. So in the sense of the storyline.
Yeah.
And yeah, I mean, I did a very fun film called F2, which did really well. It was in a comic space, but it had so much meat for, you know, there were two actresses in the film, me and Mehreen, and we both had such great parts to play. And yeah, I mean, I'm glad that this year has in general been, you know, a year where I could play different characters and strong parts. And I'm also going to start a film. In fact, I'm going to start filming for a movie which has me as a kabaddi coach.
That's nice.
So also it's not just that we are getting to play better written parts, we're also able to completely dabble in very varied kind of roles and genres, which is exciting for me as an actor. You know, I mean, it gets boring to do the same kind of role again and again. So main bahut khush hu ki mujhe, you know, ek hi saal mein maine itna alag alag kisam ka kaam kiya hai aur main kar rahi hu. And I'm also just, I mean, we've been filming for a film with Nawazuddin. It's a love story. It's called Bole Chudiya. So wo fir se wo mere liye bahut alag tha kyunki wo ek you know ek UP ke area se unke culture ko darshate hue Muslim families ke bare mein. So it was again another interesting, you know, kind of role that I have had this year.
You mentioned Bole Chudiya, and I must ask that it's also slightly based on Nawaz's true life.
Well, that's what he said. That's what they say.
That's what they say, and that's what the trailer said as well. It's based on his life. Did you ask him questions? How did you sort of discuss that with him? And of course, working with Nawaz.
I was just too amused to see how simple he is. Yeah, because he's played such intense characters on screen. I imagined him to be very. Intense, but he was so simple on sets, and I never saw him losing his cool, or I never saw him, you know, I saw him as such a simple person, and for the complexity of characters, he's, you know, he's had such complex characters that he's portrayed. I don't know how such a simple person, matlab unke andar kya hoga ye sab play karne ke liye. He was super fun actually. I really enjoyed working with him, and like every scene and every shot, na, I think I felt like it was my first film, because I was in a completely different zone, and it was just so refreshing, because we really improvised a lot. Like whatever scene we used to get, I think we used to completely start kind of behaving like how we would want the characters to kind of do it. So I think the process of improvisation with Nawaz was, I think, a lot of fun.
You always told me your family is what holds you together, and that is why you like spending so much time with them. And you're also someone who sort of does work, goes home, and sort of stays away from the rest of the events and the parties that are happening. I mean, of course, award functions, jahan jana hota hai, wherever you have to make, you're there. But even then, I think they are far fewer than what the rest are doing. Why so?
I just feel like as an actor, hamein kaam milta hai kyunki hum achhi acting karte hain ya hum achhi filmein karte hain. I don't think agar socializing aapke matlab aapka aapke personality se match nahi karta hai, it's not your innate personality or innate nature to do that. I think zaruri nahi hai, you have to make extra effort to do that. Of course there are people who you really want to be there for, and wo har wo mauka jahan par jo log mujhe, you know, jo mere liye zaruri hain, who mean a lot to me, unke liye main hamesha jaati hu jahan par bhi mujhe jana chahiye. But otherwise, I don't like stress on, achha, I have to go to this place because I have to make an appearance, because I just feel like agar aapka dil wahan nahi hai, to, you know, it's just a pointless exercise. Yeah. I don't think that gets you work either. So for everyone who thinks that, you know, they can get work because they attend a party, I think is really silly.
So an ideal Saturday day off for Tamannaah would be spending it with the family?
Well, I have, you know, my family that I spend my day offs with. I have some really dear friends who I spend my time with. So I kind of balance out both. I like to spend time with just the people that mean a lot to me.
Thank you, Tamannaah.
Thank you.
It's always such a pleasure chatting with you.
Same here, Rudrani. You always, always make a really nice interview. And yeah, we should meet soon again.
We should meet soon again. Thank you once again.
Thank you. Thank you.
Watch E Town News Monday to Friday at 9:30 p.m. only on Zoom.